In February 2007, I joined Medical Mercy Canada when they went to the Thailand-Burma border after their trip to India. The team consisted of Patty Fleury, an MMC volunteer, Hans Copens, his wife Ellen Copens, Elaine Semkuli, Dr. Myron Semkuli, and myself, Dave Lowery, a local journalist who was asked to document the journey. Our first stop was Phong in northeastern Thailand, where we visited the Medical Mercy Canada Tin Tad Clinic. The Tin Tad Clinic is run by Sai Sam, himself a Burmese refugee and a friend of Medical Mercy Canada since 1999. Sai Sam told us there was a crisis developing in a four-month-old refugee camp just across the Burmese border, as another 160 Burmese were expected to arrive soon and food supplies were low. With not much time left before leaving for our next destination, the refugee camp at Loy Kawan, Dr. Semkuli decided to see for himself what problems the new refugees faced. So, love and mercy to you and your friends tonight. I was standing in a bar and watching all the people there. Though somewhat protected by the Free Shan State Army, Myanmar military outposts are clearly visible only 2 kilometers away on cleared hilltops. Myanmar is the name given Burma by the military dictatorship. The school consisted of a one-room classroom where 2 teachers taught all ages. It soon became clear that, unless someone could supply food for the short term, the new arrivals could face drastic food shortages. As we contemplated what to do, 80 refugees were sighted walking down the hill into the camp. With only the clothes on their back and possessions they could carry, they had left everything behind and walked a minimum of 3 days to find a better life.
Oh, so one kind of seed. Now they force them to grow that, to refine biodiesel. I don't know what kind of seed like that. In our language, we say lam yai.
His grandmother had walked for 15 days, you know, and I said, poor woman, you know, I just gave her a hug and she just started sobbing. Of course, we're both sobbing.
With Sai Sam translating, Dr. Semkuli headed back to Phong to buy as much supplies as possible. Eventually, MMC purchased 200 bags of rice and quantities of chili, salt, water containers, and 8 machetes. Total cost, $4,000. At the specific request of an MMC donor, 3 soccer balls were also purchased for the camp children, and they obviously knew what to do with them. With arrangements made to ensure the delivery of all the supplies purchased by MMC, it was time to move on to Loy Kawan, the established refugee camp inside Burma that has existed for over 5 years and where MMC has financed several permanent buildings. Under the cover of darkness, we drove as close to the border as possible, then hiked the last kilometer to camp. Though forced out of their villages by the military and not allowed to enter Thailand, both governments seem to tolerate the semi-permanent settlement, and fresh produce arrives daily from Thailand via motor. One of the services supported by Medical Mercy Canada is an on-site medical clinic. Several other non-government organizations and individuals have volunteered their time to train the local Shan to administer medical care. Here, Dr. Matt Waxman from Los Angeles in the green t-shirt examines a leg wound caused by the shrapnel from an exploding mine. This patient was lucky. The Burma-Thailand border is mined extensively, and unfortunately, amputations to arms and legs are a regular occurrence. Despite the challenging conditions and with no government support, there is an established school with several teachers. Patty Fleury shows them the murals brought from Canada and explains to the local teachers how she thinks the children might paint them.
If you will take one of these,
Sean State Commander invited MMC to dinner to celebrate a $7,000 donation to the orphanage and more funds for the permanent hospital. When the adults play, so do the kids. And we're not in Kansas anymore, Dorothy. Or Alberta, for that matter. But boy, it can sure storm in Thailand, too. One unfortunate result of a thunderstorm is that a tree fell on this young soldier, fracturing his upper arm. A trip into Thailand for x-rays, for cash only please, confirmed the diagnosis.
There, a little bit above. A little bit above. Welcome to Northern Thailand. This is Making by Hans. Baking class.
From literally a Ma and Pa organization started 16 years ago, MMC has grown to approximately 250 volunteers with an annual budget approaching $200,000. Though progress is being made, the need is still great, and recent events in Burma may push the refugee problem to crisis levels. More money has been left to finish the hospital, which you see here in the foundation stage. Dr. Toon, a retired anesthetist, regularly comes to Loy Kawan to treat his native Shan people and train the medics.
Make the people in your country aware of the situation here. We need help in any form we can get. Lots of it. And it is important that for me to make my people here understand that they are not forgotten. That is why I'm here.